Hello everybody and welcome. I've been wanting to harden my network for already 2 years, but I didn't get the chance to replace this Cisco RV042 that I have here and at some other locations with pfSense. I wanted to replace these boxes with this with the PC Engines box, right? And install pfSense in them, like I've done a few times, but not for myself. However, these boxes are really pricey for me now and I have different priorities. But then I thought, virtualization is the way to go these days. And, well, I should learn it, right? And my silent server here is being very reliable, running my virtualization box, and still has some power to spare. So I have decided that I'm going to run pfSense from it and use a virtual router. Initially, I thought I would just install a new network card in here, but then I thought that if I would virtualize that on Beehive, it would be very hard to migrate the VMs elsewhere, so I decided that I'm not gonna do it. And in the meantime, I can also retire my, how is that called? The Odroid box that I got from Odroid, and it's running HA proxy, and I can virtualize HA proxy as well. So I've chosen to get from eBay this Intel i350 quad gigabit network card. And then I have here two ports for my provider, one for the antenna that comes from the ceiling and one for my DSL line. And then the other two ports, one will go to provide the whole house with internet. And the second one, as part of my hardening project, I'm going to create a new VLAN that doesn't have access to the internet. And there I'm gonna connect switches and the printer, for example. And of course, if I need to upgrade one of the devices, I can temporarily move them to a different VLAN, download the firmware upgrade, and then move them back out. As part of the project, I'm also gonna be replacing my wireless access points. I have two very old Airport Extremes with the Cisco's that I got from my employer. And those are Cisco's CAP372LEK9. They are PoE. I'm probably gonna buy a 48 volt adapter so I don't have around millions of PoE injectors here and there. I'm gonna configure them via console and have one here and one in the other room. I may also create a guest wireless network, and that will, for example, if someone wants to connect to my Apple TV to stream something, they can do that without connecting to the rest of the house and the service. And I can have, for example, specific VLANs so Airport can talk to the guest wireless devices, to my own devices, and if required, of course, to the internet. I'm also gonna be, having firewalls between the devices, so I have to log into a specific terminal to configure everything and also avoid unnecessary communication between guest laptop and NAS, for example, or between the proxy and the other computers. And that's part of the zero trust principle that we've been trying to implement at work, and that will be just an exercise. All right, just need to figure out if this card is working. I don't have the other bracket here, so I'm just gonna have it hang inside the Mac Pro and boot it up, because I'm gonna have to have some maintenance time to put that server down and get the card there. So I think I can maybe just, if I have it on top of the graphics card, it's going to touch the fan blades. So I think what I'm gonna do is install it where the USB 3 card is, and that should do it. Alright, so I found out that dealing with the Mac Pro is gonna be too difficult, so I just did survey here climbing my super rack, and I can actually install the card straight from here. So I have the current Intel Pro server adapter with a single port, and well, this heatsink is super hot, so it's usually around 65 degrees. So I don't want to use this first slot here for the network card, I'm gonna take the second one. And I can easily reach the screws there, install the card, and see what's going on. As you can see now, the card is there. There's good space between the heatsink and the next card. And I can just turn the server back on. It's beautiful how silent it is. Yeah, I think it's going to post. As you can see here, a quick LSPCI, it shows that the card is there with its four ports.